Sandra. So for today, I'm going to be sharing with you guys all the products that I've been using in the shower, out of the shower. And I feel like I haven't done a video like this in quite a while, but this is going to be the summer edition because I've been using all these products all summer so far and I've really been enjoying them. So I just decided I should share what I've been loving for the summer. I know you guys love our product video, so that's why I thought you guys would enjoy this and maybe try some out for yourselves. So we're gonna start with in shower. So before I get into the products, I am gonna forewarn you guys. I am a bit of a maximalist when it comes to shower products, just because I get really bored with one product and I really would love to be a minimalist when it comes to products, but that's just not my reality and I like to have more than one option. So I'm just gonna start with the body washes that I've been using. And first I'm gonna start with this Aveeno body wash. This is their skin relief body wash. It soothes itchy dry skin, gently cleanses while leaving skin feeling moisturized. And I really like this one in particular because this is fragrance free. So this is typically the first product I will use when I do use this. I'll use this or another body wash that I'm gonna show you guys. But typically I like to go in with this one first just because it's really simple. I like the texture. It's not like a clear looking kind of body wash. It gives my skin that nice balance where it doesn't feel over dry, but I still feel nice and clean. So this is perfect for me for the first time that I wash my body. And the other body wash that I really love to use is this Proactive Deep Cleansing Body Wash. This has salicylic acid in it. And this is bomb if you have any kind of body acne. I haven't really had body acne in a long time, but I just like to use something like this just in case. And this is really good if you only just want to use it on your back or on the back of your arms or anything like that. You don't have to use this on your whole body, but I do like to use this on my whole body when I use it. So I'll go in with this first or the Aveeno one. I don't use both at the same time, but for sure I will go in with either one of these first for my first, you know, wash. I always wash my body more than once, so that's just like my first body wash option, those two. And before I get into my other body washes, I am going to show you guys what I use to wash my body with. And it's from this company called Almoni. So it comes in these little bags and they're like these little Brillo pad sponge thingies. I ordered like a bunch on Amazon and they look like this. So they have a really nice like rough texture. And I don't feel clean unless I use something like this. You just run under the water, put whatever body wash you want to use, and you squeeze it, and it expands. But this part is the only side that I like to use. The other side, they claim is for lotion or something, but I just like to use my hands for that. But I only use this side. It's very rough in texture, but it's obviously not super abrasive to where it damages your skin. I like it because it makes me feel extra clean, and it also kind of gives you like a nice exfoliating, you know, situation. So although I do of course use a separate exfoliator, you guys are gonna see that, I still like to go in with this with one of my body washes, and it just makes like my shower experience feel extra, you know, elevated. So I like to go in with one of these, and I like the little strap because you can just hold it like this, so it kind of makes it easy for you to, you know, go in. It usually comes with three. I think it comes with like a big one, like a medium size, and like a really small little baby one. And also the Proactive one is lightly scented. It has just like a really clean smell, and it also has a minty finish. So if you guys are wondering if it has like any kind of like minty feeling, it feels very cooling on the skin. And also this has little itty bitty beads in it. So if you're someone who doesn't like to buy separate like body scrub, you can just use this by itself and you're good to go. But I do wish this had like more of like a sudsy finish. You have to use more of the product to get like that super soapy feel. The Aveeno one, you don't really need a lot to get that soapy feel, obviously, but this one you need a little bit more because it has the salicylic acid acne medication in it. So this is more of like a treatment body wash, and then the Aveeno one is more of like a daily one. So I don't use this every day, but when I do use this, I go in with this first, like I said, with the Aveeno one as well. So both of those are my first body wash options. And then I always like to go in with something for downstairs. Usually it's something that's obviously made for down there. And of course the top part, not the inside, because we all know it's self-cleaning, and if you don't, I'm telling you, it's self-cleaning. Don't be putting nothing up there, especially fragrance stuff. Anyway, I like to use the Honey Pot normal foaming wash. It's free of parabens and dioxides. It's plant-based feminine care. This is the only feminine wash I've used within the past like maybe like 2 years, because I used to use the Summer's Eve fragrance free. I used it for quite a while. It's like the pink and white packaging, the hot pink and white, but I haven't used that since I started using this. This I love. I do like the blue one a little bit better because that one's for sensitive skin. This is their refresh one, even though it doesn't really have a smell to me. And if it does, it's very faint. It says use daily to refresh. It says pump 3 times. I only need 1 pump just because I feel like I don't want to waste it. I think it's just important to have like a separate wash for your downstairs area. Unless you use something like the Aveeno, which I think is safe for, you know, the top part of your vajayjay. So this I have used before down there, because it's super like gentle, it's fragrance free. So this is a good option if you don't want to buy a separate one. But I personally like having like a special wash for, you know, my VIP section. And typically when I use that, I like to use it with this little scrubby thingy. I don't know what you call it. It's from a brand called Dylonic. This is a hypoallergenic, like rubbery, I think this is like a silicone kind of texture product. This is meant for ingrown hairs. So you kind of like gently exfoliate like your bikini area and whatever other areas you may get ingrowns in. I do get Brazilian waxes, and Brazilian sometimes you have ingrown hairs. Not every time I get them done, but sometimes I do have them. And this really, really helps with that. So I really love using the Honey Pot Feminine Wash with this together. I just feel like it takes it to another level and I feel extra fresh and clean. And I love that for me. After I'm done doing that, I go in with a more fragrant body wash option. I like to have something to look forward to in the shower. And I know that fragrance-free body washes can get a little bit boring, but I like that for my first wash just because that's when I really, really go in the most. In the second wash, I'm already pretty much clean. So I mostly like to use the second option for the scent mostly, and also just to get an extra, you know, body cleanse in, because I do like to cleanse my body twice, of course. So the two options that I have here, one is drugstore, one is not. So the two I've been loving lately are the Olay Cleansing and Brightening Vitamin C Body Wash. Love this. The smell is phenomenal. I love the smell of these just because it's not super strong. These aren't like too potent. If you've used any one from this line, like the skincare ingredient line from Olay, all of them have a nice light smell. They all smell great, but they're not too strong. So if you're someone who doesn't like a strong body wash, you would love this. I love how fresh and clean it smells, but it's like a soft, sweet undertone. So I really, really like this one. I also like this for a day body wash option. Some days, like if Kelsey and I go on a walk during the day, we do walk sometimes as a form of exercise, and when I get back in, I like to go in with this one during the day, especially because it has vitamin C, and vitamin C is a good ingredient for the daytime, of course. So I do like that. And then my other option that I love is the Living Grace Philosophy. This is a shampoo, bath, and shower gel. I only use this as a shower gel, so this is their blue one. This is a very clean smelling one. This is probably like the most clean one they probably have. I really want to try the purple one, but every time I try to get it, it's always out of stock on Sephora. So this blue one I've been loving. It's a very fresh smell. So Living Grace, I think the other one is called like Unconditional Love or something that I wanted to get. But this smell is very suitable for summer. It's very clean, very crisp. It almost has like a masculine undertone to it. So if you like a very like crisp, clean kind of scent, you would love this. So for me, I like to go in with this obviously for nighttime. I don't really use this at all during the day. This has a very relaxing smell to it. So it's very calming. I would put this in the bath just because I'm very particular about what I put in the bath when I take baths. But for the shower, I love using this as my second body wash. It's very, very nice. So if you guys are looking for like a very clean, calming smelling body wash, you would love this. Especially if you're a fan of the Philosophy body washes and you haven't tried this one, you need it if you're into clean scents. So I love how fresh and clean this one is. It's bomb. I guess I'll consider this one my third option, but it's barely anything in here, as you guys can see. So I mentioned this in a favorites video a while ago. This is still dripping. This is the Byredo Gypsy Water Body Wash. Love the smell of this. It smells like summer. It has like a lemon crisp, but still warm undertone. I'm obsessed with the smell of this. It kind of smells like Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. So if you're not into that kind of smell, then you won't like this. But if you like the Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue perfume, you would love this. I don't think I would get this in like the perfume scent, but I think it's the perfect body wash smell. Just because it's very clean and fresh. And like I said, it's the perfect like summer scent. So this is also a great option for me. Clearly I've used it all up and I have like maybe like 4 pumps left. If I'm not using the Olay or the Philosophy, I'll go in with this one. So I love this and I like how soapy this one gets. So it gets very like suzzy. Love that. Okay, so after I'm done with my body wash, like cleansing my body, I like to exfoliate. So I have 2 options here. One is a little bit more intense and the other one is a little bit, you know, more mild. So the intense option that I love is probably my favorite body scrub that I've used in a while that's just effective. I don't use it for the smell or anything like that. This is just strictly effective and something that I will probably buy forever. I just pray they don't stop selling it because this is probably their best product in my opinion. This is from First Aid Beauty. This is their KP Bump Eraser Body Scrub with 10% AHA. It's safe for sensitive skin. This is bomb. So this is my 2nd one. I will continue to repurchase this. This is a very fine body scrub, but it's very, very effective. I don't think I've ever used anything this effective. It doesn't irritate my skin. And my skin is always super, super soft after I use this. I'm obsessed. So I haven't used like Tree Hut or any of the other body scrubs that I used to love a lot. I still love Tree Hut, but this is just where it's at. It's so effective. Obviously, this is more than your Tree Hut body scrub, but for good reason, it's so, so worth it. If you have never tried a body scrub with any actives in it, this is a great option if you're looking for one. I'm telling y'all, if you are someone who likes to use body scrubs in the shower, you need this. You need this in your life. If you've got an irritated skin from body scrubs or if you have super sensitive skin, this is amazing. So I love this product. Like I said, I'm gonna continue to repurchase this and I'm just obsessed. So this does have colloidal oatmeal in it, which is why it's safe for sensitive skin. And it obviously has 10% AHA, like I said, which is a chemical exfoliator. It has glycolic and lactic acids. Both of those are really great exfoliators. Lactic acid is more hydrating and glycolic acid is very like heavy duty, like effective chemical exfoliator. This I love because it's a chemical and physical exfoliator combined. So it does have really fine beads in it. It's not like super, super like big beads or it's not super abrasive. It's very gentle. And I just take my time with this and a little bit goes a long way with this product. So you don't need to squeeze like a huge amount out because you won't need that much. And I'm telling you, you will like thank me later after you've used this after like a week. You will notice a huge, huge difference. So love this product. And like I said, it's probably holy grail status for sure. And the other option that I really like is from the brand Necessaire. I like to use this one when I need a more like calm exfoliating situation. And I'm just gonna be real with y'all. I mostly use it for the scent because it just relaxes me so much. It smells like a spa. This is the Necessaire the Body Exfoliator and this is the eucalyptus one. I love this. So if you guys are into like those very calming, soft, clean smells, then you would love this. If you like eucalyptus, this is the body scrub for you. It's a gel texture. I feel like it's a gel with little beads in it. This is just a straight up body scrub. Like there's no mistaking it. That's a body scrub. This feels more like a hydrating body scrub because it has like a gel texture. So this says it's a multi-exfoliation exfoliator. It does suggest that you use it 1 to 2 times a week or as desired. I don't exfoliate 1 to 2 times a week. I exfoliate more like 4 times a week just because I enjoy exfoliating. But this smell is like the ultimate nighttime shower smell to me. So if you're into the spa like scents, you need this one in your life. I love the brand Necessaire. And this product is probably one of my favorites. And they actually sent us a PR package and this was one of the products in it. I would definitely purchase this with my own money just because I love the scent that much. I'm obsessed with the eucalyptus scent. It's not too strong. It's very soft and light. So don't expect like a super intense eucalyptus scent. It's very light. So this does say it exfoliates, softens, and renews the skin. So I love this product as well. So after I exfoliate, I do move on to shaving. I do shave about maybe twice a week. And I always like to go in with my Gillette razor. So this is a new one. I forgot the name of it. I think it's the Gillette Pro or something like that. Yeah, and I just buy the replaceable blades. So this is a men's razor. For me personally, I've used obviously woman razors before, but they never work as good as the men's razor for me. So yeah, I've never went back to the woman razor since I started using the Gillette Pro. And the shaving cream that I'm using right now, I ran out of my sensitive skin, like fragrance-free shaving cream, but I really wanted to try this EOS shave cream with shea butter in it, and this is the lavender scent. So this smells like lavender, but a very light lavender, like it's a barely there scent. This has shave oil plus shea butter in it, and you guys know how I feel about shaving with baby oil. I love that option, but sometimes I want like that shaving cream feel sometimes. And I've really been loving this one. So if you guys haven't tried the lavender scent yet, I highly recommend. Or if you haven't even tried the EOS brand in general, they have really good shaving creams. And this one has shea butter in it. So when you shave and you leave it on and like move on to another body part, your skin is getting, you know, hydrated and moisturized as you're shaving. So I like the multitasking of the shea butter in this. I love this product. So if you guys are looking for a nice hydrating, moisturizing shaving cream, this one is bomb. It says, say hello to smooth comfort protection, and it says, say goodbye to nicks, cuts, and irritation. This is not irritating, so I highly recommend the EOS shaving creams if you've been eyeing them. I love the lavender one. Okay, so after I'm done shaving, I'll rinse the excess like shaving cream off, and then I will go in with my Nivea In Shower Body Lotion. This I've been obsessed with, especially because right when I get out of the shower, I don't go right to moisturize my body like right after. And I have heard that it's really, really good to use like your lotions or whatever right out of the shower because your body's still damp and whatnot. But I go straight to my skincare right out of the shower. So this is like a nice buffer between that time for when I do my skincare and then start with like my out of the shower body products. This is the Nivea In Shower Body Lotion, the 24-hour moisture nourishing one. So this is a water-activated formula with almond oil. It's non-sticky, and this is for very dry skin. So you guys know I'm a huge fan of Nivea. I've talked about that lotion a billion times, the one in the navy blue bottle. But this In Shower Body Lotion, I love. So if you guys have not tried an In Shower Body Lotion, try the Nivea one first. I love this one. You only need a little bit, and you just rub it in. You don't rinse it off. You just leave it on. And I feel like that's like a nice start to me moisturizing my body. That's obviously not the only product that I use for that, but I'll put that on and then I'll just, of course, like wash my hands and start on my skincare. So that's like the last step in the shower for me. Okay, so after I'm done with my skincare, I will moisturize my body. And the first product that I like to go in with is typically a lotion. So I've been loving the Aveeno Skin Relief Moisturizing Lotion. So this is pretty much the matching lotion to the body wash that I mentioned. This is fragrance free, it heals very dry skin. It has triple oatmeal complex in it. So I love how soothing this is. It also has natural shea butter. So it's very effective, but it's very lightweight. So if you're looking for a lightweight, but still very moisturizing lotion, if you're someone who doesn't really like to apply body moisturizer in the summertime, just because you feel, you know, sticky or really hot still, but you still don't want to skip that step, this is a great option. So I personally can't skip body moisturizer just because it's important to preserve your skin, and I just hate feeling really dry and cracked, so that's a no for me. But I've been loving this. It's like the perfect summer go-to lotion just because it's fragrance-free, it's very moisturizing, and it's really lightweight, so it's not like a thick, heavy product. And when I do want to go for something scented, I've been loving this Amazing Grace Firming Body Emulsion by Philosophy. I mentioned this in a favorites. I love how lightly scented it is, but it's a very like fresh, clean, powdery smell. So if you like the baby lotion kind of smell, this is a more elevated, more adult version of that. So I love this for nighttime. It also has like a nice calming scent, so it's perfect for night. and I love the texture. Like, it's very moisturizing, even though it is a lotion. So it's very like lightweight, like a slippery kind of lotion, but it leaves this nice like sheen on your skin. So I'm obsessed. So you guys should try this if you're looking for a more high-end lotion option that's still lightweight but moisturizing, and it has a nice light smell. Love this. And then my third lotion option that I sometimes go for is from Necessaire. This is the body lotion. This is the fragrance-free one. I just love how simple this product is. It's very, very effective. It has multivitamins in it. Don't know what that consists of, but I do love the formula of this. This is a body lotion, but it is a little bit thicker of a lotion. It's not super like thin of a lotion, but I do like that this seems mixable. I feel like this is perfect to mix with like a body oil. So if you love products that you can mix with other products, this is like perfect for that because it's fragrance free and the texture is really, really nice and like moisturizing. So I love this lotion. The only thing is I wish it came in larger packaging because I've been going through this really fast. Necessaire is bomb for fragrance free options, and I just love how simple the formula is but still really effective, because you know I love effective formulas. Okay, so something that's not a lotion option that I wanted to talk about is something that is probably not meant for like your body, is technically meant for the face. This is the Paula's Choice 2% BHA liquid exfoliant. This product, obviously, you've seen all over YouTube, is a cult favorite product for your skin. It's a great chemical exfoliator. But this I love using on ingrown hairs. I had an ingrown hair, it was gone in less than 48 hours. I was like blown away how amazing this works on ingrown hairs. Like I said, I do get resilience, and sometimes you can get ingrown hairs. And I love this product. I'm telling you, my bikini area, everything was just so smooth and perfect. You need this in your life. I just figured out that this was like the perfect hack if you get Brazilian waxes, whatever kind of waxes you get down there. This is very, very effective. It works really well on the skin. So I figured if it works well like on your face, of course it should work well on the rest of your body, right? So that's why I just thought that it made sense. And it works really, really well. Okay, so my last moisturizing step is typically a body oil. So even in the summertime, I like to use some kind of body oil. And I love this Palmer's Cocoa Butter formula with vitamin E. This is their skin therapy oil. So if you guys love body oils that are really lightweight, but sometimes you find that they still don't feel moisturizing enough, or like they don't, you know, work on your skin all night, because some really lightweight body oils, my skin still feels kind of dry afterwards. That's why they call them dry oils. They're all not created equal to me. This is amazing. I personally think Palmer's was made for black people, because I have not used a Palmer's product that I do not like. This is amazing. So this has argan oil in it. It's non-comedogenic. It doesn't have mineral oil in it. So if you're someone who cannot use mineral oil, this will be amazing for you. I love this product. And I just love how moisturizing my skin feels. I love the sheen it gives. It gives that nice glow. It's just amazing. As you can see, I've used quite a bit. And I have this product in bulk. I have like three more under my sink. That's how much I love this product. So I'm someone, if I'm obsessed with something, I'm going to continue to use it. There's just no point in changing it. If I try something new, I always go back to this. And for good reason. It's a drugstore product, but it's probably one of the best body oils that I've ever tried. So if you guys are looking for a good body oil, what are you waiting for? Okay, so as far as deodorant goes, I do like to wear deodorant at night, but I do like to go for more of a natural deodorant option. I don't really need like something super intense for while I'm sleeping, and also I don't feel super comfortable wearing like a Dove or anything at night while I'm sleeping, because I know deodorant is very controversial, especially these days when it comes to health and like the ingredients and stuff. But for me, I prefer to use a natural deodorant at night while I'm sleeping, because I'm not you know sweating a lot, and you know, it's just not necessary for me personally. So I've been loving the Maison Louise Marie number 4 deodorant. This is really good if you're not someone who needs a strong deodorant for nighttime. This is not for daytime. This is not if you're going for a run. This is not for that. This is just for sleeping, for me personally. So I like this. It does just enough for nighttime. If you guys have ever smelled this number 4 scent from the Maison Louise brand, you know that it smells just like Le Labo products. Le Labo has an amazing, like very unique scent to their products, and this smells just like that. Very, very nice, like a nice clean scent, but it has like that unique kind of Le Labo scent. So it smells just like those products, but this brand is more, this is a natural brand. So this deodorant is a natural deodorant. So I feel like it's really good for night while I'm sleeping. So that's the only time I use this. I don't use this in the daytime. If I do take a daytime shower, I like to go in with this Dove deodorant. So this is the Dove Advanced Care Dry Spray Go Fresh. I've been using Dove deodorant for years and it's always done me right. This is the Rejuvenate one, so the pear scented one. I love this scent for summer. It's very fruity. It goes well with a lot of my fruity perfumes. So this is really nice for during the day. Love this. I still haven't found a natural deodorant that works during the day for me. I just can't get with it. Like, I need something that's gonna last all day, be effective. If I'm sweating, you know, you wanna smell fresh all day, and I just haven't come across a natural deodorant that does that for me. Although I do really wanna try the Lumi brand. I've heard really good things about Lumi, and then this other brand called Each and Every. I saw both of them on Amazon. So if I find that I like those, then of course you will probably see them in a future video. If I still want to be extra, I should have mentioned this before, the body oil, because I always apply body oil last. This lotion is when I want to be extra. So I only use this about twice a week. This is the Miss Dior Moisturizing Body Milk. Rosita Applebaum put me onto this, and she raved about how much she loved the smell. And it's so weird because I do not like this perfume. So I was skeptical about buying the lotion, but it smells nothing like the perfume to me. This is a very fresh, girly lotion. So I love like a girly, sweet floral scent. It's not like a potent, like headache floral smell. It's a very soft, girly, feminine scent. So I love this for like twice a week because it's not cheap. So this isn't something you use every day, but it smells very luxe and like girly. And it's just like more for the weekends for me. That's why I like to spread out when I use this, but it's amazing. It's very moisturizing, although I do still recommend using something like the Aveeno or the Philosophy one first and then going in with this, because I feel like you don't want to use this on your whole body because it'll go super fast. But I'm obsessed with this. It smells amazing. And it lingers. So if you're looking for like a nice, bougie, smelling good lotion, you would love this. I love it, but I do not use this every day. This is just for when I wanna be extra. Okay, and last but not least, I like to go on with a perfume, and the one that I've been liking at night right now is from Replica. Well, Maison Margiela Replica. I love this one. This is the Lipstick On. So it's like the hot pink, rosy colored one. Probably can't even tell what the color, there you go. So I love this. I don't even know if they still have this scent, but this is a very sweet smell. So if you are not into sweet scents, then you will not like this. But I love this like right before I get into bed, and it just reminds me that it's nighttime. That's why it's good to have like a nighttime perfume, because you associate that scent with bedtime. And I just like to smell good while I'm sleeping also. So this has a very sweet, warm scent. I'm pretty sure it has a vanilla in it. I forgot the other notes, but this says the fragrance description is night blush and rice powder. It does have a powdery undertone. So if you don't like powdery undertone, like perfumes, you won't like this, but this is a very feminine scent. It just smells like a woman to me. That's why I love it. It's very feminine, sweet, soft, and it kind of has like a vintage smell. Not old, just vintage. It just smells very timeless. And that's why I love this for nighttime. If you're looking at any of the Replica scents, if you see this one, get it, because you won't regret it if you're someone who loves sweet, very feminine, girly scents. I love this. Okay guys, so that wraps up this video, what's in my shower. I would have filmed this in my own bathroom, but all these lights will not fit in my bathroom. My bathroom is a little bit smaller than Kelsey's, and I did not want to burn up in my bathroom. So that's why I filmed it here, but I hope you guys still enjoyed this video. I hope you try out some of the products that I talked about. Every time I get like a new batch of products in, of course I like to share with you guys. So I've accumulated these products over the past couple of months, and I just thought I should share. So I will link every product in the description box if you guys would like to check these out. And yeah, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see y'all next time.